Hey everybody, I am the Creative Lady, and today is Sunday, September 21st, 2014, and I want to pop in. I know it's been a while since I've made a video, and I'm just letting you know that I am on the way back, but just wanted to pop in and say hello, and I'm watching football, so I'm in between games on this Sunday night, getting ready to go watch more football, so you know I love football. This past weekend, I had the opportunity to meet Tom Joyner. For years and years and years, I've been working on this top secret project. It was an HBCU, like a collage in a sense of all the HBCUs, historically black colleges and universities. And it was my mission to give it to Tom Joyner. It started off as a quilt. It got to be too big and massive, so I had to think smaller. So I ended up with a 16 by 20 inch plaque type situation that I created. I'll insert some photos or videos here of what it really looked like. And I was able to get it to him. He was coming to town last week for the Southern Heritage Classic, the 25th year. And he was supposed to have done the girls' night out at Home Depot on that Friday night, but I guess, I don't know, the weather, too many events going on, and they postponed it. And that was absolutely great because I was putting the finishing touches on the project. So recently this week, I saw on the Oprah Winfrey Super Soul Sunday, she had Paulo, Coelho, the author of The Alchemist, and she had him on. But she's always quoted him, or paraphrased him, in that whatever you want, the universe will conspire with you to make it happen. And I've heard that for years and years and years, and I guess by some way I lived it, but to experience it in the moment is absolutely amazing. So yeah, I had been wanting to meet Tom Joyner for a very, very long time. He has been coming through Memphis a lot, but I was not prepared. But this time I said, you know what? I am not going to squander yet another opportunity. I have got to get my butt out of procrastination and finish this project. And I did. But for the most part, it was a girls' night out at Home Depot. It was fabulous. If it comes to your city, register, print out your confirmation and go. We had no problem getting in, even though it says girls' night out. I saw some men up in there, but it was a great time, well organized, lots of fun, food and prizes, and it was absolutely free. So that was amazing. So I saw this young lady when I was in the line to enter, and I had this giant bag, you know, and I'm like, oh my goodness, I hope I can take this inside. So I saw her, she happened to have natural hair, so I said, hey, everybody was friendly. But I saw her and I asked her, I said, will I be able to take this inside? And I told her what it was and who it was for. She said, sure. So we got on in, and I was sitting there, we got front row seats in this big tent thing they had set up on the parking lot of Home Depot. And I had gotten a wristband. My girlfriend had gotten like a pink band. I had a lime green band. And lo and behold, we didn't know they were going to call us into groups. And we had different groups to go to. I was like, oh my God, we're separated. So when they called my group, I was group number 8. And my group was heading out the door. And I'm like, oh my goodness. I didn't even see Tom Joyner in the corner taking pictures. That was how focused I was on paying attention to what was going on. And I saw my lady outside, and I saw her, she was FAMU, and she said, I saw her and I was like, look, lady, I need you to help me get this to Tom Joyner. She said, okay, come on. I said, what? I left my group and I followed her through the crowd to get to Tom Joyner. So we got to the front of the stage where he was taking pictures, and she got clearance from his people that I could give him the gift, and they said okay. So I gave it to him and I took it out of the bag, and I told him, I said, Mr. Joyner, I want to just thank you for all the work that you do for HBCUs, and I have made a craft for a project, and I wanted to give it to you in honor of all the HBCUs. So he took it and he looked at it. He's like this. He's like, oh, 105? I said, absolutely, yes sir. Woo! You know I'm going to research my projects, honey. I'm not going to show up unprepared. So he took it and he looked at it. He seemed to love it. So I was excited about that. And so we were taking pictures, and my lady from FAMU took my picture with him with my cell phone. And then I think some of his people may have had professional photographers there. So the pictures may be on blackamericaweb.com. I'm not exactly sure, but my moment has been made already, just meeting Tom Joyner. And we took the picture, and my friend wasn't with me. She's my roommate from college. And when I told her when we got back together, she was like, oh. So we went back up to take her picture with him. I didn't want to seem like a stalker, but she wanted to be in her photo. So I'm jumping in the photo, letting the handlers take the picture with my camera, my Canon T3i. And I asked the guy, I said, did you get it? He was like, yeah, I got it. I'm like, we went back and sat down, got out of the line. Come to find out, the guy had not pushed the button all the way down. So no, we did not get our picture at that moment. But my other girlfriend was there, and she was like, y'all need to go back. Go get the picture. So here we go again. The third time, I'm like, oh my God, I'm going to look like a freaking stalker. So he was so gracious, and we had both had on our Alcorn t-shirts, and he just was the nicest person you'll ever want to meet. Very approachable, and it was a very humbling experience. So he took pictures with us, and we made more conversation. So I am forever grateful for my FAMU lady for helping me to get this project to Tom Joyner. Now,
I experienced Paulo Coelho's message firsthand. I wanted to meet Tom Joyner. A beautiful young lady helped me. The natural-haired FAMU grad gave me the VIP treatment. She led me front and center to Mr. Joyner. I was able to speak to him, deliver the gift, and take photos.
Now, the Girls Night Out is fun. If, like I said, if it ever comes to your city, make sure you go. We got there, registered, and got our bags, and we got this Home Depot tote bag, and inside was a few little souvenirs. First of all, we were supposed to do some DIY, but you know, I left my group and I went somewhere else. But this is a wine rack that I can put together and paint, you know, do all the wonderful things to it. So I will be doing this and definitely as a DIY project on this YouTube channel. Also, inside were some other items. I think a notepad, a Home Depot notepad. And this is a Home Depot, I think this is a antibacterial hand sanitizer. And Home Depot really supports HBCUs, so that is definitely a great thing that I will be participating in as often as I can. There was also a Home Depot bandana, and there were lots of prizes and contests going on in order to win some fabulous prizes. So, like I said, if you come to your city, make sure that you go. There's also a pen. I got a Home Depot pen. And there's also, what is this, like an apron? So you can tie it around your waist and work and put your little, all of your tools that you need in the little pouches. I love it. And it says, more saving, more doing. Home Depot. Love that. It was a fabulous time. So I want to thank Home Depot and Tom Joyner, my FAMU lady, my best friend from college, and all the people in Memphis. We had a great time. The DJ Stan Bell, I mean, we had a phenomenal time. So, yeah. My mission in life is to do what I love and love what I do. I originally got that from my girl Poochie of Poochie's Closet, and I know a lot of other people live by that mantra. But I want to live my life a certain way. Anything that I would do for free is what I should be doing. I love making videos. I love sharing and empowering people with knowledge. And that's what I do. I purchased a new Blu-ray player, and then there was content on there. And I started investigating, and then lo and behold, I was given the opportunity to be a part of having my content featured on the Roku, which is a digital streaming device. You can save money on your cable bill with this, and I'll go more into that on a later video. You know I do. I'll tell y'all what you need to know. But at first, my content was kind of bundled with other like channels. But yeah, so now I have my very own channel on the Roku. So that's exciting, and I've heard from some of you guys on Instagram that you have saved my channel to your favorites. I do appreciate that. Thank you for the support. And again, I will get more into this Roku and what it really is and how YouTube can save some moolah. This hair, of course, it's still natural. I put a little color in it. I made it darker because it was like one of those muddy brown colors. It was just so blah. So, yeah. Football is about to start, so that's why I'm rushing a little bit. So I need to get back in there and see what's going to happen with Cam Newton and the Steelers tonight. All right, guys. I thank you for sticking with me. There's more to come. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.